Hey guys, the 2019 World Artistic Gymnastics Championships are about to get underway. They're held every year except when there's an Olympic Games. This year, Stuttgart, Germany hosted championships from October 4th to the 13th, with defending champions Simone, Biles and Arthur Dalaloyan looking to defend their gold medals. So that's the who, what, when, and where. Stick with me as we tell you the why you should watch the 2019 World Artistic Gymnastics Championships. Simone Biles is sure to be the talk of the women's competition.
I don't have anything to prove to anybody. I'm out there doing it just for myself this time.
She's already won 14 world titles and 4 Olympic gold in Rio. She even rocked a goat leotard at the US Championships. But she more than backed that up, becoming the first woman to ever do a double twisting, double back dismount off the balance beam and a triple twisting, double back on the floor exercise as she won her 6th US title. So for someone who's accomplished everything in the sport, I had to ask, what's left?
I don't have anything to prove to anybody. I'm doing it just for myself, see what I can do and see how far I can push myself. I feel like it just comes from the desire to want to do gymnastics and the love that I still have for the sport. A lot of the skills were kind of unimaginable, but then we turned them into doing them for real. So that was pretty crazy. Doing it for myself, but I felt more pressured to do it for other people and to make other people happy. I was pretty sure I was done, but then in the back of my mind, I kind of knew I was going to come back. But I feel like this time around, I can do it just for myself, so I feel a little bit happier.
If you liked that, then you should definitely download the Olympic Channel podcast and listen to our full conversation. So what can we expect from Simone in Stuttgart? Well, it's likely to be history at every turn. First, in the women's team competition, a medal of any color will make her the most decorated female gymnast at the World Championships. She's currently tied with Russia's Svetlana Horkina at 20. Then in the women's all-around final, she'll go for her 5th overall title. No one owns more other than Kohei Uchimura of Japan with 6. Then in the apparatus finals, she'll be the favorite to defend her world and Olympic titles on vault. But a medal of any color will tie her with Vitaly Sherbo's overall world medal record of 23. From there, she can go on to break the record and win 1, 2, or even 3 more medals as she defends her uneven bar silver, balance beam bronze, and floor exercise gold from 2018. So all in all, Simone can leave the championships with a lot of medals and a lot of records. This year's championships are extra special with Olympic qualification on the line. A total of 12 women's and 12 men's teams will qualify to compete at Tokyo 2020. In 2018, the top 3 teams earned automatic qualification, with USA, Russia, and China grabbing the 3 spots for the women. The US women have dominated world and Olympic competition for more than 15 years. In the last decade, they've only lost once, to Russia in 2010. Since then, it's been all USA as they took the titles in 2011, 2014, 2015, and 2018, along with Olympic gold in London and in Rio. In the individual all-around competition, an American woman has taken the gold medal every year since 2011 when Jordan Weber won the title. A year later, Gabby Douglas was Olympic champion, and then Biles dominated, winning in 2013, 2014, and 2015, and the Olympic Games in Rio. Morgan Hurd was a surprise champion in 2017 before Biles returned to claim her crown. Speaking of Morgan Hurd, after all-around podium finishes at the World Championships in 2017 and 2018, she'll be looking for more of the same in 2019 and at next summer's Olympic Games in Tokyo. But first, she might face her biggest challenge making an incredibly talented US squad. We caught up to Morgan to talk to her about her mindset heading into the most important year of her life.
It's the biggest competition of the year, so it's very important to perform well. Plus, you want to represent your country well. And not only that, but this year is even more important because it's leading up to the Olympic year, so that's when selection's really going to start. There's a lot of pressure just because the U.S. The U.S. is basically expected to dominate just because of the amount of depth we have, so there is a lot of pressure there. But right now, I'm really just focusing on just making the team versus putting that pressure on myself already. I might try to put in some upgrades, maybe, but if they're not working out, I'm not going to do them at all. So really, it's just perfecting absolutely everything down to the very little things.
Now, I've seen those upgrades, but you'll have to watch episode 3 of All Around when it premieres on October the 2nd. Along with Hurd and Biles, Team USA has amazing talent to choose from Riley McCusker, who finished second place at the Pan Am Games in July, to Sunisa Lee, who was a surprise runner-up to Biles at the US Championships in August, or someone like Jade Carey, who's the 2017 World Silver Medalist on vault and floor. But no matter who the US sends to Stuttgart, they are likely to dominate the women's competition. The battle for the silver medal will likely come down to Russia and China. For Russia, their leading senior gymnast is Angelina Melnikova, who was second at April's European Championships and won 2 gold medals at the European Games in June. She'll be joined by Daria Spiridonova, the 2015 World Uneven Bars co-champion, and World's newcomer, Lilia Akamaeva in Stuttgart. For Melnikova, she comes to Stuttgart looking for her first ever individual major medal. In the lead up to Rio, she showed incredible promise, but a disappointing qualifying round found her watching all of the individual finals from the stands. In 2018, she was 5th in the all-around final and a devastating 4th place in the floor exercise. We asked her how those experiences give her an edge in 2019.
Выступать не сложно, когда ты в хорошей форме. А вот когда ты не успел подготовиться, вот это уже ты будешь испытывать некоторые проблемы. Тоже очень важен, потому что там соревнуются те же страны, весь мир. И я думаю, что стать чемпионом мира – это очень почетно и очень важно для каждого спортсмена также.
A year ago, the Chinese team, led by 7th place all-around finisher Chen Yole, took the bronze medal. Since that competition, Chen has been plagued with injuries. She had ankle surgery in late 2018 and is dealing with pain in her wrist, but she has returned to full-time training. Her goal, no matter her individual form, is to help Team China win another medal this year at the Worlds. Take a listen. Another star not to miss in Stuttgart is France's Melanie De Jesus Dos Santos. She's had an impressive 2019, taking the gold medal in the all-around at the European Championships. I went to see Melanie when she trained alongside Simone Biles in Texas and asked her how just missing out on Rio 2016 has fueled her journey to Tokyo.
J'étais comme ça. Elle est vraiment impressionnante. J'admire ce qu'elle fait tout le temps, tout le temps. Et ben, je suis très contente de m'entraîner ici avec Simone. Je pense que toutes les filles qui sont en France ou même dans les autres pays rêveraient de rencontrer déjà Simone ou bien même de s'entraîner avec elle. Donc je pense que j'ai vraiment beaucoup de chance d'être ici. Forcément, ça motive. Après, je sais que je dois encore travailler parce que j'ai encore évolué si je veux être sur le podium mondial.
For Tokyo 2020 host Japan, this is their chance to qualify to the Olympic Games. They'll need to finish in the top 9 teams yet to qualify to the Olympics. Should be easy for the team that finished 6th place a year ago, but they'll be doing it without their star, Mai Murakami, who's out with a back injury. Instead, they'll turn to youngsters like Hitomi Hatakeda, who we asked what it would mean to represent her home country next year in Tokyo.
日本代表に入って世界選手権にもう一度出場して団体でメダルを取ることを目標にしています。まあ、今回世界選手権に出てみて、まあ、特別だった自分の憧れの舞台に出れたことはすごい嬉しかったんですけど、やっぱりオリンピックっていうのは4年に1回しかないものなので、しかも2020年は東京オリンピックで一番特別な機会だと思うので、そこは逃さず出場したいなと思います。
In Stuttgart, there'll be world titles on each of the four apparatus and an all-around competition where the athletes compete on all four events. The team competition sees three gymnasts competing on each apparatus with all scores counted. So there's no room for error. Let's move on to the men. China, Russia, and Japan have already qualified to Tokyo 2020, but Olympic qualification is still on the line for the rest of the teams. Also on the line is a chance for Russia to win its first team gold medal since the breakup of the Soviet Union, which dominated the sport. Reigning world all-around champion Arthur Dalaloyan wants to make that dream a reality.
На этот год самая главная цель вот для меня, мне очень сильно хочется, чтобы мы командой именно достойно выступили на чемпионате мира и все-таки завоевали это долгожданное золото, наверное, для России. Вот для меня это самое вот огромное желание и то, что меня мотивирует каждый день приходить в зал и работать. С работой, то есть не на себя, а вот именно командой хочется взять это золото. И я думаю, что получится и ребят всех зажечь, и довести к чемпионату мира так, чтобы мы звенели и были в такой же хорошей форме, как на том чемпионате мира.
He won't have to do it alone. Nikita Nagorny, whose European Championships total is the highest score of the season, and David Beliavsky, who finished fourth in the world in 2017, are sure to help in what's likely to be a battle with reigning champions, China. For Japan, it's the start of a new era. It'll be the first World Championship since 2009 without the legendary Kohei Uchimura. Uchimura, who is arguably the greatest male gymnast of all time, has won 6 world all-around titles. But since taking gold in Rio, injuries have kept him from full strength at each of the last 2 world championships. He's still determined to compete at Tokyo 2020 and recently returned to competition in the all-around. But Japan still has plenty of firepower, including Kakaru Tanagawa, who in 2018 became Japan's youngest men's all-around champion ever, and handed Uchimura his first defeat in a decade.
ま、今年の目標は世界選手権に出場するして金メダルを取るっていうのが今年の大きな目標で、まあ、その来年東京オリンピックがあるので、まあ、それに向けていい1年にできるようにしたいなっていうふうに。
They'll need those good results to hold off the U.S. that finished a close fourth in 2018. The American star is Sam Mikulic, who won his 6th U.S. title in August. He's more determined than ever to live up to his incredible potential after a heartbreaking miss in the final rotation of last year's all-around final kept him off the podium. I talked to him about his new approach this season at the U.S. Championships.
I think this Olympic cycle, I've put a lot less pressure on myself. Gymnastically, you know, I found a lot of balance in my life with social, you know, got a little family going on with the pups and the girlfriend, and I'm just in a very different place in my life where, you know, other things that I thought were once important are no longer not important at all. And my biggest goal after last year's World Championships with being so close in the all-around finals is to finally get myself up onto that all-around medal podium.
There'll be individual titles along with another set of all-around and team medals up for grabs in Stuttgart. So let's go ahead and take a look at the schedule for the World Championship. Official practices run September 30th to October 3rd. That's the one and only opportunity for the athletes to train on the competition equipment before the championships kick off on October 4th, with 4 days of qualification. The first medals will be awarded on October 8th with the women's team final, followed by the men's on the 9th. The women's and the men's all-around titles will be decided on October 10th and 11th before the championships wrap up with 2 days of apparatus finals on October 12th and 13th. We'll be in Stuttgart bringing you all the action, including our daily live blog, live streams on social media, and video highlights from training, along with post-event reaction and more. So make sure you're following at Olympic Channel on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and be sure to check out Olympics on YouTube for archived gymnastics content and some fun features throughout the championships. You're all set for the 2019 World Artistic Gymnastics Championships. Stay with Olympic Channel for more.